Hi, it's Mark. In this video, I'm going to be revealing the investing strategies that I used to go from beginner investor with very little money to multi-millionaire by the age of 35, and how you can do the exact same thing. So I've got a simple question for you. Do you want to be rich and have the freedom that comes with being financially stable? Many people do. Why do you think there's so many get rich quick schemes out there? Most people though, unfortunately, have a lottery mentality. They're just waiting for the magic fairy to come down and hand them $1 million. Do I look like the magic fairy to you? If the answer is no, and I really hope it is no, then smash that thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel. The truth is, lots of people think that winning a chunk of money will make all your problems just disappear. But they'll be in for an absolute shock. Without the correct investing and mindset strategies, it will be all gone, and in no time, you'll be back to square one. You need a solid, consistent investment plan, which gradually builds your wealth over time. Long-term investing will give great returns. When I was younger, I always wanted to be a race car driver. I just loved everything about cars, but I didn't have enough money to pursue my dreams. But as I started building up my investments, it allowed me to race in multiple championships and win countless trophies like this. I even got my helmet here, look. You sometimes see it at the back of the shots. How cool is that? My investments even allow me to spend time having fun making these YouTube videos, like the one you're watching. I don't currently make any money from this channel, and you can sit back and relax because I'm not going to try and sell you something at the end either. There are so many different investments out there. It's super easy to get distracted by the next shiny object. It's also confusing when you have someone telling you that this is the best thing, the latest and greatest, and if you don't invest, you could end up losing thousands. You may have heard of Bitcoin, penny stocks and short selling, but I found the key for me is not to get overwhelmed and distracted by the latest trends. Now you've got to face it, you are never going to be an expert at everything, and by consistently changing your investing strategy, you ultimately end up with less money, and at some point you're going to make a big mistake. I have nothing against experimenting, but I've kept my main investments very consistent over the years, and I make sure to only invest large sums of money into things that I understand completely. I'm not going to pretend that I have all the answers, but I am going to be completely transparent about everything I've done that's helped me acquire a multi-million dollar net worth. I'm a businessman and not a financial advisor, so I don't consider this financial advice. It's just what I've done and it's worked for me. First of all, you need to create more disposable income. At the end of the day, you need money to invest, and the more money you have, the better, especially during your 20s and 30s. Now, lots of people will say to you, save, save, save. Don't go out with your friends. Don't drink that overpriced coffee. Don't buy that nice car. I don't completely agree. Of course, saving is a big part of this, but you have to enjoy your life. There's really no point making yourself miserable just for the sake of saving an extra few dollars. You should focus most of your time and energy on increasing your income. You can do this by learning new valuable skills, having a side hustle, or building a scalable business. You don't have to settle for money you get from your 9-to-5 job. You need to be focusing your time on finding ways to supplement or replace it. When I was in my early 20s, I realized my income as a carpenter earning less than $3 an hour was never going to give me enough money to invest. It hardly even paid my bills. I needed to find a way to dramatically increase this, and this is when I started my journey into the business world. Investing and business really work hand in hand. The saying is very true. The more you learn, the more you earn. And most importantly, the more you can invest. Be really aware of your lifestyle and make sure to keep it in check. Just because you're earning more doesn't mean you should be spending more. Think of someone like, say, I don't know, Ed Sheeran. He has a huge amount of money, yet he keeps his lifestyle in check. He still enjoys the little pleasures of life. If you were happy making, let's say, $40,000 a year, and you managed to increase your income up to $100,000 a year, that means you've got an extra $60,000. This should be going straight into a high interest savings account, and then into your investments. You know, you don't need to be spending it. Well, there is one slight exception, and that's stage number two. Pay off all your high interest debts. If you have student loans, credit card bills, or even a payday loan, then these are pulling you down. They're destroying your credit score, which ruins your ability to take advantage of good loans. By paying off these high interest debts first, you'll actually save more money than you could ever hope to make elsewhere. The next stage is to create a freedom fund. This is my name for an emergency fund that puts the power back in your hands. This freedom fund consists of 3 to 5 months of living expenses. It protects you if you decide to quit your job, as well as a lot of other situations such as recessions, depressions, or even worldwide epidemics. Okay, so you've increased your income by learning a valuable skill, or maybe invested in your own business. You've kept your lifestyle in check, you've paid off all your loans, and you've created the Freedom Fund. Now, and only now, is the time to start looking at other options. Let's start off with the lowest risk option. Index funds. An index fund is a collection of investments that you can put your money into and own a percentage of the entire thing. This gives you a fantastic diversification and protects you from poor stock choices. For example, let's say you got $1,000 and you invest it in, let's say Apple stock. As they're a big company, right? They're going to be safe. As soon as your money goes in, the company takes a turn for the worse, causing the stock price to crash. The result could be that you lose the majority of your investment. This is where index funds come in. Instead of owning just Apple stock, you could take that $1,000 and invest it in something like the S&P 500, which gives you small shares in Apple, as well as Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, Visa, Disney, and many more. You're a shareholder of all these major companies. Now, if something happened to Apple, it would be balanced out by the other investments in your index funds. Now, lots of people will try and convince you that a mutual fund is superior. A mutual fund is very, very similar to an index fund, except it's controlled by a very smart person whose job it is to pick the stocks in the fund. The purpose of a mutual fund is to try and beat the market and get better results for the investor. However, in the vast majority of cases, you'd be much better off putting your money into a simple index fund with less risk and often a greater return. This is because index funds charge extremely low fees. The S&P 500 charges 0.07% annually, and mutual funds charge high fees, between 1 to 2% of your account balance annually. If you invested $10,000 into a mutual fund, then $200 would go straight into that fund manager's wallet every single year, even if he caused you to lose money through poor stock choices. On the flip side, if you had the same amount invested in the S&P 500 index fund, then only $7, yes, just $7 would be leaving your account annually. This is because index funds are passively managed and therefore don't have to pay a manager who may or may not be doing a good job. For long-term investments, I love using Vanguard index funds, as I like these. They're so easy to use. I'm not affiliated with Vanguard in any way. I just like the way it works. I also like to mix it up a little bit with some international funds and bonds to diversify my portfolio even more. The older you are, the more bonds I recommend you invest in. And I don't mean James Bond either, although he is pretty cool. The investment method I put the majority of my money into is real estate. I am much more of a real estate guy than a stock guy. I like real investments I can feel and touch. But I appreciate that it can be hard to buy properties with little money, but it's certainly something you should be saving for. My first property was a one-bedroom apartment, and I loved it. It was mine. It cost me around $50,000. And when I moved out, I decided to rent it $500 a month. I had this property for around about 10 years, and when I sold it for $150,000. And after this, I was obsessed with the money that we could make from real estate. Now, this is a good time to decide which type of investor you are. The first type is a capital gains investor. This is someone who likes to buy low and sell high and pocket the difference. These are investors that are interested in buying houses of auctions, or you may have seen the signs outside advertising that "we buy your house for cash." They like to take advantage of the situations when people want fast sales. They may then move into the house, do it up, and flip it for a profit. They have to keep repeating this process. This can work very, very well, but it is subject to fluctuations in the markets on a year-to-year basis. The second type is a cash flow investor. This is the kind of investor I like to think I am. I'll never buy a property if the rent won't cover the mortgage. I like to follow the 1% rule, meaning if I buy a property for $100,000, then at minimum, I want it to bring me in $1,000 a month. Otherwise, to be honest, I'm not buying it. Now, let's talk about one of the most risky options, individual stocks. I get asked about this type of investment daily, and I understand why. Individual stocks are a very attractive choice to lots of people. This is because with a small investment, you can buy into the market and sell whenever you want. Unlike real estate, when you have to look for a buyer and go through all that whole selling process, at a tap of a button, you have complete access to your funds. When I was in my early 20s, I looked at a few different companies and I invested $5,000 in single stocks and shares. And I'll tell you what, that was a lot of money for me back in those days. And within just 6 months though, I'd made a profit of $100,000. And with that, I could buy a massive warehouse, which really drove my business forward. Make sure you understand what you're investing in. I see many people investing in stocks because their friends said they should. If you don't understand it, it's quite simple. Don't invest. I use two methods of valuing stock. The first way is called quantitative analysis. Something that might surprise you is when you Google the price of a stock, that isn't the actual real value. It's more an estimate. I like to look at the company's quarterly earnings reports, which includes things like balance sheets, income, and cash flow, to get a real sort of feel for the value of the company. You can easily find this information on the internet. The second way is called qualitative analysis. This isn't about the actual numbers, but more about the abstract qualities that make a company great. A good example of this is Tesla. There is something special about Tesla, from the CEO Elon Musk to the raving fans that are his customers. I also like to take into account the future value of a company based on how their technology will live in the modern world. I believe the move to electric is inevitable, and Tesla are at the forefront of this industry with the most extensive network of superchargers and availability of product. If you do decide to go down the route of individual stocks, then make sure to create a diverse portfolio. Don't just use one sector. You've got to use different things like healthcare, technology, various different things. You really don't want to leave yourself open to huge losses. If you're interested in this, I'll put some links below where you can find some really cool books. You can do this on some great apps, such as M1 Finance, Robinhood, and if you're in the UK, you can use Freetrade. I personally like to control and add value to my investments. I want to be able to see how my money is being spent and use my experience, my contacts, to be able to sway the odds in my favour. This brings me finally to my private business investments. This allows me to mix buying shares with my own business expertise. Think Shark Tank and Dragon's Den, but on a much smaller scale. I regularly get messaged about investment opportunities, and in return for my money and knowledge, they give me a stake in their business. Recently, one of my connections out in China contacted me as he wanted to give me shares in his new hotel supply business. This is me and him at the biggest independent hotel show in the UK. He needed someone he could trust that understood the business landscape and also spoke English. He wanted me to help open the doors and the opportunities for him in the English-speaking market. He flew me out to China so we could inspect some of the supply chain and also give me a good idea of what we could offer our potential clients. Now, the nice thing is, I'm extending my house at the moment, so I was able to get all sorts of building materials. Even a nice hot tub. It's on its way. Should be nice. We'll have to do a video from there one day. But I'm not sure you're going to want to see that one. It might be X-rated. This is just one of the ways that improving your skills and contacts can be a great investment, as it allows you to secure much better deals than somebody who's just offering cash. It can even sometimes lead to free shares in another company. You're going to love this next video. I'm going to leave it just here, but don't click on it just yet. You've guessed it. Destroy that thumbs up button. I really appreciate it. And finally, consider subscribing to the channel if you're interested in increasing your income, and hopefully I'll see you in the next video. What are you waiting for? It's just there. See you later.